Hello, I'm Mr. Harniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Today I went to Oxford to attend a lecture or seminar rather by a professor, Jørgen S. Nielsen, University of Copenhagen, who was on Islamic, lecture studies. Professor in, you can call it Islam. And it was held at Oxford Center for Islamic Studies, George Street in Oxford. Now, it was 5 o'clock, the lecture. So I catch my bus, and with me was sitting a priest, who was a Methodist, and then he was a Baptist, and this and that, Church of England, about preaching for 20 years over, still, doing his thing. And I engaged him in discussion, talk, and started to tell him, that about gospel, giving him the expositions, such as who was the person thrown out of the wedding banquet, Judas Iscariot, and other things. But he wasn't showing much interest, he was just saying yes, yes, but not, showing much. So I didn't bother much with him, But I told him, Church of England is headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon. As soon as you say that, then they understand this man knows the secret that the Church of England is not devoted to God but to Mammon. So then they don't want to talk with you anymore because that's their secret. However, I went to Oxford University and this professor, he gave that there are so many Muslims in Denmark, so many in England, so many in this country, that country. And Muslim, he was giving them the, because of their saying prayer, their form, not of heart, just of ritual. So also he was talking about secular and spiritual, but he was giving Muslim a secular identity, not spiritual. So in the topic was in Europe, who is Muslim? It seemed to be quite interesting, but when the question time came, they happened to, they did not know, that I will ask them awkward question. I had this t-shirt on with no Christ in your heart, no gospel and all that. Would be. So they asked me to ask the question. I told him, God is spirit and so is Allah spirit. So Allah is free. He, in spirit, is a no laws. So Allah did not make any law, because if he makes law, he will be bound by the laws. So he is spirit. And where from this Sharia comes in, and this Mullah. Now the person here understood, this is a question at the hitting at their heels. So he asked, warned him, no, don't forget about it. Don't answer him. So I said, okay, no problem. So I told him there's a InshAllah mean God be willing. And this Islam you are talking about is of InshMullah. Because it's a Sharia there. Mullah is the one who enforces Sharia. Allah doesn't enforce Sharia. However, they were sore, because this, where from this man comes and asks awkward questions, and there were audience, there were white people sitting there, and all that. They were all listening to him, and they didn't ask me, you know, any question. So after they have finished this session, and the people asked, they had spoke in their own language, that means in the same type of language they were, that they are Christian in a secular term, not spiritual. A Muslim is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So they were all discussing outwardly Muslim, not inwardly. So when everybody finished, then they were, I just wanted to go out, and there was some drink being served. I said, okay, let me have some sip there. So I joined them. But they were not so happy to see me in their company. So I kept quiet, you know, because it's no good to spoil their show or to say anything. But I was a bit surprised that how these people, you know, they are brainwashed. Islam, submission to the will of Allah. As Christ Jesus, when he was coming to Jerusalem, James and John went to a Samaritan village, asking them to get ready to receive Jesus. And the Samaritan people said, no, no, let him go, we don't want him. They came back to Jesus, put that village on fire as Elijah did. But Jesus said, you don't know what spirit ye are of. I have come to do the will of my Father, not my will, and that is called InshAllah. So this Islam which you are seeing is of Mullah. Mullah says he is the Imam, you know, and this man said, oh, as in church they have bishop, in Islam they have Imam. Again, he doesn't go by what is the definition and what is reality, but what is going on, what is popular. So when you go by what is popular, then you go follow the wide road with the wide gate, and that leads to sectarian riots. So these people who are creating Muslim and Christian and all that of physical selves, they are heading people to sectarian riots. In fact, these bishops, mullah, and all those who come between man and God, they are all antichrist. And antichrist for their own popularity. They have fanatic, a mountain of fanatic, and they fight with each other and kill each other. Now situation in the world is getting very bad, and as you can see, this attack on Iran or anything country like that, you know, Syria or anything going on, there is soon going to be a trouble between Christian and Muslim, and when that trouble goes bad, erupts, then there is going to be sectarian riots in the countries, like in Nigeria, Christian Muslim sectarian riots, and other places. So these all are caused by Antichrist, because Christ Jesus preached Islam. So this Muhammad also, when these Messianic Jews, they were misusing Islam, and they were Antichrist, light came among his own, and they hated light, loved darkness. So when they created this bishop, pope, and other thing, that killed people by putting them before animals, then Gentile could not stay, quiet, you know. That's why they came up. And Muhammad, he was a Gentile, very nice man. So when he saw all these things happening, he gathered some people, a core, and then he started spreading Islam, which is parallel to what the Christianity was. In Christianity, they had a bishop, and he put imam there. And as I explain in other videos, this you need to look at carefully, because Gentile, their rabbis, they were not corrupt. It was Jewish rabbi who were corrupt. So the Gentile had a good system, which they carried on, and they understood that this is the age of Islam, but they had mullahs which were very good, not dishonest, honest people. But when this Islam went to India, the epicenter of the sons of Satan, then those mullahs created by India, especially Kashmir, they created all this problem. Otherwise, Islam is a good way of through, but the real Islam is going by Inshallah, where you can't impose the views on another person. As Pope was imposing view by killing people, those who disobeyed, so was this Mohammedan start imposing views. So this topic is to be best discussed face to face and on good understanding. But what this professor was doing, he was putting oil over the burning fire, not water, but over the oil on the burning fire. He will be promoting sectarian riots, because if you keep the religion as spiritual self, then you have peace. Because this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam. And this I explained earlier many times, that 2,000 people came to attack our village of Arai tribe, and we are Jat. So when they came to attack our village, the headman of the attacking party asked the manual worker who has incited him, you know, that, oh, we are going to attack them, to bring out the person who say they want to attack. So my father with his elder brother went there to see him. There were no arm, nothing, just empty-handed. And that man was sitting very proudly on a charpai. And my father also sat on that, and so his brother. He was not happy to see them sitting on there. But as soon as my father explained to him that Muslim and Christian, they are spiritual self. They are never born, never die. We just going to die in this fight, and you are I going to die. If there is any enmity between our tribes, let's settle it down. It's a good chance. When everything was explained to him, he came to his senses. He said, we have no enmity. We, Jat and Rai, we are friends. We are like brethren. So he asked those 2,000 people that these people are our guests. No harm should come to them. So instead of attacking, they returned as our best friend in Allah. Now most of the university professors who teach Islam, ask them, why you call Allah? What is the origin of Allah? Hardly anybody can tell what is the origin, because they don't know the basic. They have learned the dead books, and they teach the dead letters to their students, and then they promote the dead letters too. Islam is not of the dead Allah. Allah is living. So unless you are a living person in spirit, you cannot understand Islam. So Islam is submission to His will, and Allah is from the word Illah. Illah used to be tribal god, you know, in the Kaaba. Each tribe had its own god, which was called Illah. And there were 360 or so. And Kaaba used to be for children 12 to 16. They used to keep Kaaba on their right hand side to go around Kaaba. But when this Hazrat Muhammad Sahib came, they said, no more Illah, no more tribal gods, but Al-Illah. Al-Illah means the father. No more tribal fathers, but one spiritual father, which is Al-Illah, the father. So this makes a better sense than God, because inheritance of the royal kingdom of God is to the sons. And Allah makes it clear that He is Father and we are sons. These people who are Christian, they don't know God, who is God, whether He is Father, and some call Him a Lord. When they call Him a Lord, they make Him a son of a Satan, because lords have slaves. Slaves have no authority or no right to occupy the royal kingdom of God. So there are many things that could be said, told, but as you know, living God, the living gospel of our living Father, is for the living in spirit people, not for the dead in letters, as these university professors are. You see them sitting there, and they know only the letters of the books. And if you ask them a question, who created Adam and Eve? They have no answer. Adam and Eve, two flesh. What is born of flesh is flesh. What is born of spirit is spirit. They have no idea. It is Yahweh who created Adam and Eve. In Arabic, we call it Khuda. In Hindi, we call it Brahma. So, plenty of knowledge, but you have to have face-to-face discussion to enjoy it. In preaching gospel, we do not impose view or make disciples. If you make disciples or your followers, then you become an antichrist. So these people, mullah, bishops and popes and all that who make disciples, they guide them, you know, do this thing, do that thing. They are antichrist. They are going to cause sectarian riots in different countries. So you will see how people will kill each other on the basis of their religious affiliations. Our Father God blesses you.